The players took to the dripping pan pitch for the annual REMF Challenge Match, with the Albion looking to win back the trophy they'd lost the previous year. Before kick-off, a minute's silence was held in memory of the charity's namesake Robert Eaton and those on both sides who are sadly no longer with us. The Seagulls' first opportunity came when Jack Judd was brought down near the box and Lawrence Edwards produced this sublime strike. In response, Palace couldn't find the target as this header went over the bar. Brighton then came forward again, Michael Standing's effort falling just wide of the mark. But it wasn't long before the Seagulls' lead was doubled. Judd sent Standing through down the wing. His cross was inch perfect for Declan Brewster, and whilst he may have scuffed his first attempt, he recovered well to make it 2-0. From there, Palace came out in search of a goal and could have got it, as this free kick caused chaos in the box, which the Seagulls eventually cleared. And it could have been three, but Kyle Woolen's fantastic ball into the box was just a matter of centimetres away from a head. Down the other end, a Palace free kick caused pandemonium in the box, with the ball finally falling to Ryan Scott, who went for this spectacular effort but couldn't beat the keeper. And the Eagles should have had a goal back not long after. It was against Scott, who went one-on-one through with the goalkeeper, but somehow missed the target. Palace kept coming forward though, but Albion keeper Jake Thurmer was determined to not be beaten. Into the second half, and Palace continued their search for a goal as Scott set up Ryan Wallace, who somehow missed the target from the edge of the box. Meanwhile, the Albion couldn't find that third goal that would have put them out of sight. Toby Phillips heading over from close range. Down the other end, Scott blazed over as frustration grew for the visitors. But the Eagles would eventually level the game from 12 yards. Carl Southwell was adjudged to have handled the ball in the box, and Jake Newton stepped up to convert to make it 2-1. In reply, Edwards couldn't replicate his first half strike to give them their two-goal lead back. And Palace kept themselves in it as Brighton were denied yet again late on. But the one-goal cushion would be enough for the Albion as they win back the REMF Challenge trophy.
This is Brighton v Crystal Palace at the end of the day. The rivalry is strong and everybody knows it. We've got the Brighton fans, they turn up. We've got the Brighton players. We have the Crystal Palace. We have the Crystal Palace fans. They all stand together and for this, everybody comes together. So today, I think at the moment, there's been about £8,000 raised and it's still coming in. So when you look at it like that, that rivalries are put aside for something like this, it's been fantastic and it's been really, really good. And it's been a lovely evening. It stayed dry and it's been a good turnout tonight.
Took a bit of time coming, but they played well today. Started the game really well. Boys up front were lively and we looked like we were going to be comfy winners first 10-15 minutes, but we dropped off a bit, they got a bit better, and as usual we let a goal in and made a game of it. But yeah, I think we deserve winners, but it was close.
It's just fantastic. You know, we've had a couple of fundraisers this year that we've raised a lot of money for. I did a marathon and I raised money for that as well. Like, it's just superb. You know, and Palace aren't that bad, so they're not too bad. Although they were very kicky today, very kicky.
Hopefully we'll be near 10, so you've got the gate, there's a raffle gone on, and I sold a few hundred tickets, so hopefully it'll be good to... It's nice to come back to Lewes. We done well, we got the win. So we're happy, we can go and party like a Brighton player. Everybody's come down on a Friday night, they've taken their time out, they've dug into their pockets, they've spent for the raffle at the ticket desk to get in. Just thank you very much, because without all these people that donate, without all the players that turn up, without everybody else that does it, we can't have our charity. And so because of that, I thank them very much. Thank you.
So congratulations to Brighton, but thanks to everyone involved in this year's REMF Challenge Match. The charity raised over £9,000 by the end of the weekend. A fantastic effort from all involved, and we look forward to seeing the challenge back next year.